One universal trait amongst the human species is our never-ending obsession with time. Rather than living in the present, we dwell upon what the future may hold. The decisions that we sow today are done in order to be harvested later. In most cases, fear and anxiety stem not from what is happening now, but what is waiting for us tomorrow. It was said by the writer Khalil Gibran, "Our anxiety does not come from thinking about the future, but from wanting to control it." The question arises, while our actions do influence future events, is it possible to control the future? Throughout Quantum Break, the story hammers home a specific theme. The past is fixed, but the future can be changed. During Junction Points, Paul is able to witness these alterations when he makes a decision. For the rest of us, this is not possible. We will have no way of knowing what the result will be when turning left or right. During the game, there are several instances of this theme played out. The biggest example is an Easter egg right at the start of the game. In usual Remedy fashion, the writers make references to both pre-existing literature and real-life figures. Let's take a look at one of these, as they are always relevant. The narrative begins with Monarch Solutions preparing to demolish a historic landmark, the Riverport Library. It is easy to miss, but this library is dedicated and named for the meteorologist Edward Lorenz. While working on the mathematics of weather forecasting, he made a discovery. At first, he was focused on variables related to weather forecasting, such as temperature, pressure, and wind speed. In 1961, this work took a turn when the computer simulation gave a radically different prediction than the previous one that used the same variables. The problem was the computer itself. The computer tracked variable data to 6 digits, while the printouts rounded it up to 3 digits. This minute difference in the data accounted for a radical change in the prediction, proof that minor variances can have large consequences. After this, Edward Lorenz became known as the father of modern chaos theory, or scientific study of complex systems. The pursuit of unraveling seemingly random or unpredictable behaviors in systems governed by deterministic law. Echoes of chaos theory can be seen all throughout the narrative and world of Quantum Break, the most obvious of which being Monarch itself. The name and logo of the company is based upon monarch butterflies. This is because one basis of modern chaos theory is the so-called butterfly effect. Each junction point acts as the proverbial flap of the butterfly's wings, sending the narrative down one path or the other. But the connections don't end here. The expression about the flap of a butterfly's wings originated from a meteorologist, saying that if the theory was correct, one flap of a seagull's wings would be enough to alter the course of the weather forever. The expression was later modified to be a butterfly instead of a gull, for poetic reasons. I wonder if it is a coincidence that Monarch based their operations on Gull Island. Based upon the fact that minute changes to a system will send the flow of time down a radically different trajectory, one question is answered. According to the math, every one of us has the power to change not only our lives, but the world as a whole. The downside is that predicting exactly how our actions change the world is impossible. Beth's attempt to save the lives of Catherine and Anthony Joyce led to their deaths in the first place. By controlling the present, she attempts to change the outcome of the future. The game began with a time machine failing, causing the fracture. This occurred literally because the math was wrong. The first quantum ripple in the game is cast when William notices the error, stating that they were missing several variables in the equation. This gets to the center of the issue. Variables that are outside of our knowledge. A precursor to Lorenz in the field of chaos theory was the French physicist and mathematician PIERRE-SIMON Laplace. One of his thought experiments later became known as Laplace's demon. If one was able to know the position and motion of every atom in the universe, one would see the past and future as easily as the present. In essence, if one knew every variable with infinite precision, one could predict the future. The trouble is, this is impossible. The Monarch scientists missed entire variables, and Edward Lorenz's forecasts were only off by 3 decimal points, which led to radically different outcomes. Imagine having to be precise to an infinite number of decimals to an infinite number of variables. I say again, this is impossible. Chaos theory comes in when the knowledge of the system is flawed. Paul's plan failed because of his imperfect knowledge of the system. Let's look at several variables that disrupted his attempts to control the future. First, whether Will was dead or alive. Act 1 concluded with the apparent death of William Joyce. From Paul's perspective, he was dead, and therefore he did not need to include him in the calculations moving forward. Another set of variables is Beth Wilder. He had knowledge of her and her death, however by believing her dead, he didn't realize she was working inside of Monarch. By having no knowledge of this, Beth was able to assist Jack in accomplishing his goals. Martin Hatch is another. He considered him a friend and a supporter of the plan. Hatch, however, was a snake in the grass and successfully destroyed the treatments Paul needed to remain coherent. The most important gap in his knowledge is the understanding of the end of time. More specifically, what caused it. The fracture that occurred in the Ground Zero site was widely believed to be the origin that led to Zero State. Based upon his first-hand knowledge, Paul gave Monarch until 2021 to prepare. In the data, Admiral and her projections found the Meyer-Joyce field to be degrading much faster than originally thought. Much like how the slight variation in Lorenz's weather prediction created a widely different outcome, there are variations between what Paul believed the data was and what it actually was when Admiral measured it. While never addressed directly in the game, this is because the fracture did not cause the end of time. Something else never shown in the game does. Paul believed this false premise and made all of his decisions based upon the flawed outset. All of these variables acting together ensured Paul's failure. Despite his ability to literally see the future, he was unable to control it. Maybe if he had a better understanding of this chaotic system, he would have been able to better predict the outcome. One of the primary themes throughout the narrative is whether or not the future can be changed. Quantum Break's final line of dialogue directly asks this question.
One more question. Paul Serene's entire philosophy was that time is a set path, and nothing can be changed. At the time, you obviously disagreed. But after everything you've seen and done, we need to know. What do you believe now?
The polarized philosophies on this topic can be found amongst our two primary characters, Jack and Paul. Jack believes it is in our power to change the events of the future. Paul believes the future has a fixed point that cannot be changed. Let's go back to chaos theory for a mathematical difference between these two beliefs. One way of visualizing the system behavior is through attractors. This is defined as a set of states toward which a system tends to evolve. In other words, all variations a system can have. An example is the motion of a pendulum. Due to gravity, the pendulum will start at the highest point and move in a spiral until it is no longer in motion. This is an example of a fixed point attractor. No matter how long, how heavy, or how high the pendulum is when released, every single time it will move to the same point. While variables may change, the end result is fixed. This is Paul's philosophy. No matter what actions are taken to fix the fracture, the end of time will always come. As a result, his efforts are better suited to what comes after this event. Another type of attractor that is relevant to the plot of Quantum Break is strange attractors. Unlike fixed point attractors where the initial conditions or variables only change the journey and not the destination, strange attractors change both. Much like the weather in Lorenz's models, one small change can have a radically different outcome. A perturbation is a slight change in the system, in other words, altering a variable. One could argue the junction points and quantum ripples are perturbations. These changes only affect what is inside of the link system, however. Jack accidentally knocking an invitation to the Monarch Gala into the trash will not affect whether or not two asteroids will collide in the Andromeda Galaxy. There are only a set amount of changes this ripple can have on the world. Again, unlike a pendulum, which can be represented by a spiral, these ones are more complex. One famous strange attractor was made by Edward Lorenz for his weather modeling and called the Lorenz attractor. While each projection goes in different directions at different speeds, there is only so many variations possible. These variations form a three-dimensional model and, coincidentally, it looks like butterfly wings. What it shows is that despite these infinite variations being different, they all obey certain patterns. Perturbations to the system create possible outcomes in the multiple timeline sense. This brings us back to the question, is it possible to predict the future? Based upon the mathematics of chaos theory, yes and no. While in the short term our actions can control our immediate future, we are unable to predict the long-term consequences of our actions. This is because the further in time we go from the initial perturbation, the more variables present themselves. we cannot know a variable that will present itself next week, so how can we account for it now? Weather forecasts work this way. It is easier to predict tomorrow's weather than it is the weather for the next month. This may be why when Paul sees the potential futures for the junction points, he only sees the immediate future over the next few days. Otherwise, he would know exactly how the story would end for him. At the end of the day, the lesson to be learned from chaos theory is having more data is always better. If in your personal life you have a goal, gather as much information as you can before jumping forward. A misunderstanding or incomplete knowledge may cause the road you travel to veer off into unexpected places. The more we know about the system we find ourselves in, the better chance we have of making the right choice. Pulsarine showed us that having the wealth, the power, the resources, and the influence ultimately means nothing in achieving your goals if your understanding of the system is flawed. Thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed, please drop a like, as it really does help out the channel. If you would like updates on new uploads, feel free to subscribe or follow me on Twitter. Have a good day, and peace be with you all.